Hi, welcome back. In today's video, we're going to be playing on the Russian side. We're using these 44 Yagov Strakovy up against the Korok 559. And they're both infantry divisions. Ours is a very standardized Russian infantry division, whereas theirs is a reserve division. Got a whole bunch of different styled light tanks, some are outdated, and they've also got some stolen T-34s, where we've got a whole bunch of T-34, 76 and 85 model. Then their infantry, they've got a whole bunch of different types of infantry that they can bring in, whereas we have the standard Guardvia and Sapieri. So we're just bringing our sappers up. They're gonna try and push this town with the support of these two T-34-76s going up against their T-34-42. TNT drops in, managed to take, completely blow up this building, and it forces the other one to surrender. And now tanks are starting to move up and exchange with this T-34 on there. Does get hit by some TNT though, so it's caused these guys to panic. So we do take out that Panzer T-34 and secure this flag. Over here though, we only had a MG set up, so they've kind of taken that out and are pushing down. Over here, we were going to bring up a couple of AT guns. Instead, I've had to unload them on this road, so they can try to push back whatever's moving down this cliff side. As we start to bring up some Guardias, T-34 and a sniper team. Over in the center, Allies done a pretty good job pushing up this town. We've got our own MG just kind of helping hold this town. And then over on the right side, looks like the enemies, we've managed to kind of just hold them in this area. Kind of no one's getting any flags at this moment. We are now bringing up some Guardias. They're gonna come and start pushing through this area, try to retake some of that free land that we gave them. Because we were under fire, we decided to stop before pushing forward into this forest. If you are running your infantry, what I noticed just from previous games is while your guys are on the move, if they're shooting at your guys, it's a lot easier for them to take them out, whereas if they're standing still, then they are less likely to lose a lot of guys in one go. Then you can kind of just try to suppress them with your support units or with artillery or planes, and then once the guys are pinned down or falling back, then you can continue moving to the destination. T-34 coming up now as we start to move our guys through this forest. They've got these interesting Panzer T-60s with the autocannons. You can only bring up, I think, like a couple of those. It's like one or two. Oh, actually, no, sorry. You can bring up about like four of those. But there's some of these light tanks. I think it's like these Kampfpanzer 3Es. I think you can only bring up two of them. There's a few light tanks where you can only bring them in phase A, and you can only bring up just a couple of models. You can't kind of spam them out like you normally can with light tanks. Nice hit on our guys there. We actually didn't really have any AA at the time, so we've just put up these ZSU M17s. We've got the quad autocannons. Moving up our sniper team so we can start to scout out anything that's going to try to move onto this town. Yeah, the three goes down. So we just moved up the Sapphire and Guardia, and now bringing up a bunch of SG-43s. They're gonna try and just hold this area for defense. basically now stuck on this cliffside as we've cut them off with our ZSU. And they're under fire from our Guardias, so we're now going to start dropping some mortar fire onto them. Our leader squad coming up now. AA flak coming up now. Gonna try to secure this left side for any armor that tries to push through. And we're now just starting to bring up one of our tanks. Just wanna see if anything tries to take a shot at it before we bring over a Guardia. Since this Guardia managed to get across quite safely, I decided to race our next one over. It does actually get hit by this ME410. And over here we're now actually running into some trouble as they bring up these T-34-41s. Not much our Sapphires can do against these guys. So we've just unloaded our flak cannon. Try to get him into position, see if we can take these tanks out. Our Sapphires go down. Take out one. Unfortunately, I'll pin down though, so he's no longer going to be able to win that exchange. But with some smoke, we've managed to send our Guardia over into this building. We've now got our SG-43 set up and our T-34 moved up for support. Got a couple more SGs over here, so I have to stop anything from coming from this right side. As we start to bring up another flak cannon. Guardias that we brought up, they're now starting to push into these houses, make sure we can hold this flag, while our others are just kind of going to use this forest for cover. As you can see, as soon as they get to about here, they're going to be safe from vision. Just moving our mortars up as well, so they're in a better position. Just get that smoke screen in time to race across without losing too many men. And our Gardier did take this town, or take this house. Just lost vision, and we did see a tank there, but we lost vision, so unfortunately we couldn't hit it with those rockets. There it is there. Just managed to get him before he escapes off map. We've now rolled up these T-34-85s. These are the more powerful 145 pen with 110 frontal. And then they're just going to start stopping this push that they've started. Sniper team's also going to start taking them out, as we start to bring up our AT gun, which will help. With some smoke, we managed to slowly move this second Gardier squad over. Now that our flak cannon's here, it's going to be able to put a lot of pressure on their armor and aircraft. They're all in a full retreat by the looks of it. So they managed to hold this flag. And we're now going to bring over some sappiers while there is still a little bit of smoke. Looks like it's dissipating pretty quickly though. We should make it okay. Another flak coming up with some recon. I noticed that they actually did. Pretty sure I had a recon unit over here somewhere, which they took out. I've still got my sniper here though, so that's fine. And we've still got a sniper back here, providing range for our tanks. Powerful rocket barrage comes down on our guys though. Just to knock out our leader. It's a lot of rockets. quite well though. They must have been dug in pretty well. I don't really know how they survived that. But we are starting to move our tanks up onto this right side so that we can start pushing up our sappiers. While our guardiers are going to secure this forest. In the flat cannon that got him. Take out that infantry gun. Here's a TNT. With the help of a strafing run from our Yak-3. And we've managed to secure the bottom end of this town, and now we're bringing up our guard gear. They're going to try and push forward. Do we have a Tiger E sitting back here? They can shots at our P-34/85s. Hopefully just from the range alone we can not lose these tanks. But I decided to pull him away anyway, and just to try to stay out of his range. Sappiers do get taken out. Looks like he's gone for a rocket barrage on our flat cannons. Since we did lose our SG-43s over here, we've got two here that we're going to bring up. Our mortars are now starting to hit these guys. So we've now taken this flag. Plenty of Oldsmashniki and Guardiers coming up. They're going to get ready to make a push over onto this forest here. The Yaks is coming to try to take out that tank buster. There we go. other Yak was just going to try to suppress these guys down here. But it looks like he was taken out. Forming run there from our F1B. And now we're just moving these Auto Smash Niki over and the guard gears over to this side. Getting some recon in position along with these SG-43s. These SGs here just in time as they were trying to come and take this flak from us. Another flak cannon coming up on this side, along with a couple of T-34-85s. Now our Auto Smash Niki are coming up. Heavy bombing over here, just in case there was something there. I wanted to knock it out of place. And then I've got some mortars just hitting this side over here. Try to soften them up before we move up. Some more guard VAs coming up. We're gonna just try to help secure this town for good. Here, ally is actually losing this fight. He's being pushed back pretty badly. So we've now got this flag, plenty of units to defend it as well, and we're now just moving up our guard gears, along with another flak coming up. Probably should have moved this guy up, but that's alright. A whole bunch more of guard gears and sapiers. Just want to really cement our defense now that we've taken so many flags from them. These rocket barrages are really painful though. I should have tried to either snipe their artillery with our own artillery, or try to maybe push a little bit further, try to see if I can get to it, maybe even do some bombing runs. But yeah, it's done a really good job of attacking our fortified positions. just lucky that it wasn't backed up by an actual attack. One of the great things with rockets is you can kind of just hit an area, pin everything down as you're pushing, so it makes your push a lot easier, and you can actually pretty much just wipe out whatever was in that defensive spot. But instead, he's just kind of using it to pepper my guys without any follow through. So it's not really getting the results he's looking for. Guard gear's coming up. Some more coming up. And some more up here. Just trying to swarm this area with infantry. Try to get a couple more units into this town, considering we've got just a single guy holding this entire area by himself. He does have the backup of these SU-152s though, so he's not in any trouble, but it'd be good to have some mates with him. Superior coming up. And we've also brought up these T-34-85s. On this pathway here, make sure that we can hold this flag. Large buildup of units over here, though. I wasn't really paying too much attention to my ally side. Until I think now, I think this is when I decided to look over to see how he was going, because I noticed our flag was still only at 13, even though I'd captured so many new flags. Did lose range just before our IL-2Ms could fire their rockets. Another rocket barrage there. This is going to keep hitting our guys, I think. Let's bring up some recon now, since we did lose our other recon squad in there. Gonna have one come over on the side here and one over here. Unfortunately, they were flying down a little bit too low and had to dive or kind of fly back up so they didn't run into this cliffside, which has then caused them to do a complete turnaround before they'll hit those tigers. Meanwhile, their tank buster just completely annihilates our T-34-85. So I've decided to come in and try to help my ally push these guys back. Now that this is pretty well defended, I can kind of just ignore this side for now. We've got a couple guard units, they're gonna hold these buildings, make sure the flag's not lost. I've got some recon coming up, they're gonna provide vision of all these units that are trying to push through this passageway. Guard units on the left flank, or guard units on the right flank, and they're just gonna sweep through this forest. also got this FLAC 85mm coming up. That'll basically be able to stop any of those armored units coming through. I actually brought this field battery up, but forgot to use it. Oh, it ends up getting taken out by rocket fire anyway. Yep, so we've managed to push them out of these forests. I've also got these T-34-85s coming up. These units are still trying to flee in this passageway. Recaptured this flag, nearly recaptured this flag. We're just going to start sending our infantry down now that they are in a full retreat. Another flak cannon coming up as our tanks are now going to start moving along this left side, infantry on the right, and then just going to leave a couple back here while the other two move up. I wasn't really paying much attention over here, but looks like they've just been hitting us with rockets. A couple of small pushes over here. They are running into these Ordismashiki though, with the PPSHs, so they can win pretty much any exchange that happens in those dense forests. Let's bring up some scouts. And T-34-85. Taking out that Tiger and Pack 40. So I'm now now to race over into these buildings. Also gone and taken this flag here just by moving up a couple of our guardias. These flaks are just putting so much pressure onto these infantry units. Any moment you just hang on. Trying to move these guys up to stop them from finishing off our squad. Nice game. So it's a major victory. 3,000 kills to 2,100 losses. Thanks for watching.